Naoya read a book cover to cover in a single session at a rate of 55 pages per hour. 55 pages per hour. After reading for 4 hours, he had 330 pages left to read. How long is the book in pages, and how long did it take Naoya to read the entire book? Well, there's a bunch of ways that we could approach this. And like always, pause the video and try to figure it out. But I will go with one way first, and then maybe I'll tackle it in another way. So one way is, let's just set up a little table here. And on one column, let's think about how long Naoya has read in hours. So we'll just call that time, T for time in hours. This is how long he has read. And in this column, this is how much he has left to read. So let's just write that L, left to read. And then this is going to be given in pages. So let's see, we don't know at 0 hours, we don't know how many pages he has left to read. If we knew that, at 0 hours before he's read, that the pages left to read, that's gonna be the entire book. So that would answer this question, how long is the book? So this is gonna be interesting. We don't know what happens at 1 hour, after 2 hours, after 3 hours, but they do tell us that after reading for four hours, he had 330 pages left to read. So after 4 hours, he had 330 pages left to read. So based on this, and the fact that he's reading at 55 pages per hour, can we back up to figure out all of this? Well, remember, every hour that goes by, he has read 55 pages. So if he's read 55 pages, remember, this 330, this isn't how many pages he's read, this is how many he has left to read. So after every hour, he has 55 fewer pages to read. So at 3 hours, he should have 55 more pages to read. So this should be at 3 hours, 330 plus 55 would be 385. And let's see whether this makes sense. So when our change in time, this triangle is just the Greek letter delta, means change in. When our change in time is plus one hour, our change in pages left to read is going to be equal to negative 55 pages. And that makes sense. The pages left to read goes down every hour. We're measuring not how much he's read, we're measuring how much he has left to read. So that should go down by 55 pages every hour. Or if we were to go backwards through time, it should go up. So at 2 hours, he should have 55 more pages to read. So what's 385 plus 55? We'll see, 385 plus 5 is 390, plus 50 is 440. So he'd have 440 pages. And all I did is I added 55. And then after reading for 1 hour, he would have 55 more pages than after reading for 2 hours. So 440 plus 55 is 495. And then before he started reading, or right when he started reading, he would have had to read even 55 more pages, because after 1 hour, he would have read those 55 pages. So 495 plus 55 is going to be, let's see, it's going to be, add 5, you get to 500, plus another 50 is 550 pages. So time equals 0, he had 550 pages to read. So that's how long the book is. But how long does it take Naoya to read the entire book? Well, we could keep going. We could say, okay, at the fifth hour, this thing's going to go down by 55. So let's see, if this goes down by 50, we're going to get to 280. But then if you go down 5 more, it's going to go to 275. And we could keep going on and on and on. Or we could just say, look, he's got 330 pages left to read, and he's going to, let me write the units down, pages, and he's reading at a rate of 55 pages per hour. This is the same thing. This is going to be equal to 330 pages times 1 over 55 hours per page. I'm dividing by something, the same thing as multiplying by its reciprocal. So 55 pages per hour, if you divide by that, that's the same thing as multiplying by 1/55th of an hour per page, is one way to think about it. And so what do you get? The pages cancel out, pages divided by pages, and you have 330 divided by 55 hours. 330 divided by 55 hours. And what's that going to be? Let's see, 30 divided by 5 is 6. 300 divided by 50 is 6. So this is going to be equal to 6 hours. Now we have to be very careful. You might want to write 6 hours here. But this is 6 hours after this point. 6 hours after that point. So in total, it's going to take him 10 hours. At 4 hours, you had 330 pages left to read, and then there were 6 more hours to finish those 330 pages. So it's going to take a total of 10 hours. And we can also see if this makes sense. If he reads 550 pages in 10 hours, if he reads 550 pages in 10 hours, what's his rate of reading? Well, 550 divided by 10, that's going to be the same thing as 55 pages per hour, which is consistent with what we just read, that he reads at 55 pages per hour. Now, another way that you could have tackled this, you could say, hey, this is going to be a linear equation. If you're well versed with your linear equations, you could say, look, he's reading at a constant rate. And if we're talking about, let's say, let me just set up a function here. We could say left to read as a function of time is going to be equal to, he's reading at a rate of 55 pages per hour. So the amount he's left to read is going to go down by 55 pages per hour. So it's going to go down 55 pages every hour. So you could write it like that, plus whatever the initial number of pages were, and then you could use this information right over here to solve for b. We know that when time is equal to 4 hours, we know that when time is equal to 4 hours, that the pages left to read are 330. And so you get 330 is equal to, let's see, negative 55 times 4 is negative 220. Negative 220 plus b. And then if you add 220 to both sides, you're going to be left with, on this side, you're going to get 550 is equal to, these cancel out, they add up to 0, is equal to b. And so the function that describes how much he has left to read, the amount he has left to read as a function of time is, well, he's reading 55 pages per hour, so the amount he has left to read is going to go down every hour. That's why we have that negative there. So negative 55 pages per hour times the number of hours plus 550. So if someone said, well, how long is the book? Well, that's going to be L of 0. That's going to be how many pages he has left to read at time 0. And we see that L of 0 is going to be 550. When t is equal to 0, let me write this down. L of 0 is going to be equal to 550. When t is equal to 0, this term goes away and you just have 550 pages. And just like that, we could have answered this question. And then you could say, well, look, if the book is 550 pages, and if he's reading at 55 pages per hour, how many hours is it going to take? Well, 550 pages divided by 55 pages per hour is going to get you 10 hours. And we could have done that here, actually, now that I think about it. Instead of saying 330 pages divided by 55 pages per hour and say, hey, that's going to take us 6 more hours from this point, we already knew this. And we could have said, look, if we have 550 pages to read and we're reading at 55 pages per hour, it's going to take us 10 hours. So you see, there's a ton of different ways to solve these problems, and they're all really, at the end of the day, representing the same thing. That's what's neat about mathematics. They're just ways of representing how to think about things, and at the end of the day, we're really just thinking about the same problem, just representing it with different ways and different symbols.